Why, look. It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet 10 times the demon his father was.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that'd earn you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands. And he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him, and he'll lead you straight to your prize.
What the?
Despite the waywardness of your enterprise here, I understand
that you are men of discernment.
Morning, gentlemen.
Burford, Manning, to me. We've done with this place.
Aye, sir. What's our course?
We'll return to the plantation and there take stock of our inventory. It was a good harvest this year.
You might not talk so loud, sir. This isn't anything like a friendly port, Ken.
Nonsense, man. I had a delightful conversation with a chap just now. We came to quite an understanding.
As you say, sir.
All up and unfurl, boys. We're going home.
Hold!
Build some fuel.
There! After it! Hurry!
I've got a deadline on it!
You think you can escape up?
The look of a man crafting a bold idea. The look I've seen before.
You mark well, Andy. I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping there, and it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea.
Hold on it. There's trouble afoot.
I see them.
Luso, let's move!
Till armor
sir!
Who's talking
to you? There, sir!
I think we've
coming
lost them,
after
sir.
Us, sir! Qatar! Royal Bloody Navy! Seems to be alone, sir!
This man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantations, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked a plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled? Or something else?
Cane juices. It's a hard process making sugar. Dangerous, too. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like? Toiling on a plantation day and night.
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers to crush the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, it was time to boil away the waters from the sugar mill. This we did in Thatcher's mill. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin will stick like birdlime and burn on, leaving a terrible scar.
Jesus. It's a risk to anchor too close. The soldiers roving the plantation would catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackal.
What's happened here? Why such disarray?
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get pickled on duty?
No bother, sir. We've everything sorted.
We'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed. By pirates, if my eyes honor me, though the ship was uncommonly large for such rascals. Certainly wasn't slavers, though, not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch, and keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man! You've a job to do!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
God's sake, what the hell is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're piss drunk and barely able to stand?
Forgive me, sir. I am fit and able. If I see any strangeness about, you'll hear the bell ringing straight away, I promise.
I'd like to speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dogs has the key to the warehouse, huh?
Is there no one sober here? Fetch me the warehouse key, if you please.
The key, goddammit! Someone find me the key!
Interloper! Raise the alarm! Alert! Alert!
Christ, there he is!
That was a mistake!
Loose the bins, have sails!
Crowd on every inch of sail!
Close down, man your sheets!
Done it.
in the galley, nothing in the hole. Skipper's turned in with a bag of gold. Then we wait for the day, wait for the day, wait for the day, then we get off. Our horseman nest, they sprang a leak. Here I pour out in the creek. And we wait for the day, wait for the day, wait for the day, then we get off. We pumped our way round Scalby Nest, when a wind back round to west northwest. We're waiting for the day, waiting for the day.
We're heading for Thompson's gallery.
Get off.
Party now, Mitrunks.
Haul down. Haul down.
Captain's overboard.
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous, and free, and out the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
Truth. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. Would make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. And I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
Jackdaw handles knives. Pinched her from the Spanish, was it?
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
1,000 times that. I reckon £1,000,000 worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil! Love! I reckon. Might have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against merchants and such.
Well, that's some soft talk coming from a pirate. But as it happens, I mostly agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way. Here she goes. No telling what you may find out here.
Like staring through a waterfall.
Don't soil your breeches, lads.
I got this.
Down's all but me!
That ship's a monster. Look at the size of her.
Aye. And we'd not last long face to face with her. Hear that, Kenway? Keep your distance. We'll strike when fortune favors us.
Under cover of darkness, most likely.
Ah, you may come to that.
Douse the royals and come!
Read before, men! Fall in the topsails!
Loose all and trim sharp to the wind! Shorten sail! Get off the squall!
More sail! Give me more sail!
Reef in all top!
As
much sail as you can!
Loose topsails, gallants and royals!
Eat her sticks!
Douse those gallants! Haul! Haul!
All sail! She'll take it!
Crowd
trim the yards off the wind!
Mainmast! Bring in the top
half! Crowd on every inch of sail!
We ride the wind for all she's worth!
Douse the royals and tops!
Four! Haul up all but me!
Guns out! Let's get moving!
Aloft, lads! Check those royals!
Friend of yours?
Not a man I call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but respect the man.
Captain, look, Fortress!
young boy! Still alive, Captain.
Mortals, can we?
Charles Vane slinking off with his tail between his legs. That's good news for us.
Bleeding bastards! We'll have to deal with them fast. Forget the galleon!
Sailing for that island.
I know the place. Natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian Ducasse, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on't. Maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.
Captain's trick.
Unfold, mates! Let's move! More sail! All...
To larboard, sir! Wreck survivor here, sir!
Captain, looks bad!
Ask the Royal to talk!
He's the main muzzle of Galilee!
Crowd on every inch of sail!
We ride the wind, for all's his worth!
Gentlemen, as is custom among our kind, we do not plunge headlong into folly on the orders of a single madman, but act according to our own collective madness. The object of our attention is a square-rigged galleon, and we want her for the advantage she'll bring Nassau. So I'll put it to the vote. All those in favor of storming this cove and taking this ship, stomp and shout aye!
Aye!
Those who oppose, whimper nay!
Never was the King's Council so unified.
Thank you.
¡Alto!
¡Vuelve! ¡O lo haremos por las malas!
Thank you. Atacando ahí. Creo que puedo darle.
Listo para disparar.
Enemigo a tiro, señor.
Ahora, tengo una pregunta para ti.
¡Tú, detente! ¡Detente! ¡Espera un momento! ¡Esto!
Thank you.
muchachos! ¡Double time!
¡Alto! Quiero hablar contigo.
Remember the gift you gave me? Well, it answers just fine.
Fist of putain! As bold as a musket ball, and still half as sharp.
I'm sorry about this, mate, but I can't risk you telling your Templar friends about me still kicking around.
I pity you, Bukenyi. After all you have seen, after all we showed you of our order, still you embrace the life of an ignorant and aimless rogue.
What's this?
Is petty larceny the extent of your ambition? Have you no mind to comprehend the scope of ours? All the empires on Earth, abolished, a free and open world, without parasites like you! Que l'enfer que tu trouveras soit le fruit de ton insouciance.